Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. During my time with the Muslim and the non-Muslim interfaith community, and indeed through my interactions with the people who are not committed to God or do not believe in God, I often get faced with certain very fundamental pressing questions to do with God, to do with the life of this earth, to do with the relationship of God with human beings. With that, the very fundamental and the first question that we are going to deal with is, well, if God is all-knowing, then why did He create us just for us to act out what He already knows? In addition to this, there is also a problem to do with devotion to God. We are told to constantly thank God for the opportunity of life. We may ask, well, had God not created me in the first place, He would not have needed to bestow upon me. When He creates me and creates me in a state of need, then where is the bestowal? Why should we be thanking God in the first instance? And if He knew that we will either be good or bad, and accordingly reward us and punish us, then that makes God the most oppressive being in the entirety of our existence. No parent, knowing that their children will miserably fail a test, put them through that test. Now, this particular issue is squarely based on an assumption. The assumption is that we were nothing, and God decided to bring us out of nothingness and make us into something, and then bring us into this world and then charge us with obligations. And if we were to abide by what He commands us, then He will reward us. And if we do not abide by what He commands us, then He will punish us. That assumption needs to be checked. If we look at it rationally, it doesn't make sense that without our consent, God should send us to this world and to test us and then to reward us or to punish us. And then in addition to that, God says He is needless. So why would He create us from nothing? The Quran is very clear that human beings sought the life of this earth. The Quran gestures to our pre-existence or pre-worldly existence, that we did exist. And in that existence, we yearned to be in this worldly existence, and hence God has done a favor for us and sent us here. Look at the verse. Indeed, we offered our trust to the heavens, to the earths, and to the mountains. Obviously, heavens, earth, and mountains here means the inhabitants of the heavens, earth, and mountains. All of them refused to bear the trust and they were frightened of it. But the Quran says human beings bore it. The Quran does not say that the trust was offered to humanity. It says it was offered to the heavens and the earth and the mountains. Human beings were not offered, but they eagerly wanted to take the opportunity of coming into this world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then made it possible for us to arrive into this world with everything that we see. And hence, when Allah says He gave you a body, hearing, seeing, thinking faculties, and these are bestowals because these are the apparatuses, the bodily needs that you have in order to avail yourself from the journey of life so that you can avail yourself and make the most of this opportunity of life. And in that way, it's a bestowal. We were not forced to come here, we wanted to come here. Therefore, God prepared all the means for us to exist comfortably within the earth and to avail ourselves from the opportunity of life. Similarly, the Quran gestures, and when your Lord took from the children of Adam, from their loins, He brought forth their descendants and made them a witness against themselves. And He said to them, am I not your Lord? They said, indeed you are. He said, least on the day of Qiyamah, you turn around to me and say to me, we did not know. Or that you may say to me, our forefathers did otherwise. They did not acknowledge you. We blindly followed them. So why do you make us accountable for something which was a natural product of our human condition? God says, least you turn around and say this to me on the day of Qiyamah. I want you to remember that you wanted to be upon the face of this earth to avail yourselves from an opportunity of life in which you recognize me. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gestures at this pre-worldly existence, that you were dead. We brought you to life, we will cause you to die, and then we will bring you to life again. The Quran does not say you are not, and we caused you to exist. The Quran says you were, but you are in a state of death. What is a state of death? The state of death is inactivity. There is a potential for activity, but we do not have the limbs or the eyes or the ears or the thinking brain through which we can interact and act. So therefore, that means a state of passivity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states this again and again within the Quran, that you were dead, He brought you to life. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ لَيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He created death and life. The creation of death means that death is a state that comes upon human beings. Life is a state that comes upon human beings. Human can be reckoned as water in an analogy upon which the states of hot and cold successively emerge. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, هَلَتَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانَ حِينٌ مِنَ الدَّهَرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Has there come upon human beings or humanity a time frame in which they were not worthy of mention? So they were, but they were unworthy of mention. And they were brought into an existence where they become worthy of mention. We pre-exist the life of this world. And in that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not even offer to us whether we should come to the earth. The offer was made to other than human beings, to other creatures. But human beings eagerly wanted the opportunity, and hence Allah made this opportunity, created the mechanisms of death and life, the states of death and life, so that we easily progress and migrate into this world and migrate out of it. And if we can understand that, then we can understand that it was our want that has brought us into this world. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.